Johnson C. Smith's assistant Ronnie Enoch subbing for Vanessa Taylor, telling the team exactly what he wants them to do, and they're getting it done. But early St. Paul's getting some baskets. DeAndre Brown with the steal and the score. And this time, St. Paul's trying to move it, get a couple of baskets. Brown misses the shot, but Alicia Hardley gets it, and she's going to score. But things really aren't looking that good for St. Paul's because Shania Cunningham gets the pass and goes to Raquel Davis. Davis goes inside to score, and this girl right here was bad. Tyra Brough, 7-10 field goals, ends the ball game with 23 points, scores right there. Then Brough, who also has 4 assists, goes inside to April Smith. Smith gets one and goes to the free throw line. She's happy. She should be happy. The whole team should be happy. How about this? Smith inside, 10, goes to 13. That's Brittany Neely. Brittany Neely says, hey, y'all, give me the ball anytime I can. I'll take it and I'll score with it. Couple of shining spots for St. Paul. There's one right there. DeAndre Brown once again with another basket. But I'm telling you, ooh, watch that move right there. Brough gets a little screen, drives. Will anybody stop this girl with the left hand? Brough scores. Gwen Jackson Turner, the St. Paul's coach, telling the ladies, come on, girls, we got to do something about this. We got to make some plays. But Shante Bell said, coach, it don't matter how much you talk, I'm popping threes. There were 56 fouls called this game, 34 on St. Paul's. Tough game. 5 St. Paul's players foul out of this ball game, and that means that they got to play with 4 players at the end of the ball game. But it doesn't matter because Jasmine Stevens is going to score right there. Even with 4, she still gets 10. But Jocelyn Smith, too many players, too good a team. 76-41, JCSU 7-0, the Lady Golden Bulls. They are